Here's the tease. You're going to get a chance to learn how to control your distances with a clock method, and it's a drill that you can do at home. It's from Randy Chang, one of the top teachers in the world. We're helping you with the basics of your swing. If you subscribe right here below to Golf Tips, we're going to help you with all aspects of getting better at the game of golf for beginners and those advanced folks. Randy's going to help you right now.
Hi, my name is Randy Chang, Director of Instruction here at the beautiful Journey at Pechanga Casino and Resort. Today I'd like to talk about how to control your pitch shots, how to be more consistent with ball striking. And like the touring pros, most of them are practicing every single day. They use one club and they learn 5 to 10 different techniques and different swings. I'd like to just teach you one technique, use different clubs to do the same thing. We call it our clock method. I want you to imagine your body as a face of a clock and your arms the hands of the clock. With that, when we do our L to L swing, we go from 9 o'clock here to 3 o'clock. So that would be, say, our half swing. We are now gonna go 8 o'clock, club a little bit past parallel to the ground. I'm gonna match it back up again to 4 o'clock. Now, the key to this is the tempo. This is something that will help you right now. Your instincts are gonna wanna go from one position to the other, and you're gonna try to accelerate like what we've been told, right? That acceleration also creates inconsistency of grip pressure and a lot of the mishits that we see, fat, thinner topping it. So, when you get to your 8 o'clock to 4 o'clock with the club I have here, say a 56 degree or sand wedge here, I wanna feel like I want the speed that goes back is the same speed I go through, right? So with that shot, with this club, if I just do an 8 o'clock to 4 o'clock, whatever that distance is, I gotta record that. The next one will be 7 o'clock. Now I eliminate any risk from my swing. I just maintain that letter Y, and I'm going to follow through to 5 o'clock. I still wanna do my pivoting. I still wanna maintain constant grip pressure. I still wanna maintain the feel of even tempo or speed going back and through. So my 7 to 5 with this particular club goes whatever that is. So now you have 3 shots here with this one club. My 7 to 5 goes just about that distance. So here's a really neat drill to do. 7 to 5, 8 to 4, and then 9 to 3. So now I can record 3 distances here with my 56. I'll go ahead and take my 60 degree. I'll take my gap wedge. I'll take my pitching wedge. I'll do the same thing. Record which distance goes with what club at what time. Try that, you'll be able to start to control your distances, control your trajectories with just one swing mechanics. If you have more questions or you need more help, come visit me at my website at randychangpga.com or at pechanga.com. We'll see you soon.